So my name is Rodolphe Barrangou. I'm an associate professor at NC State in the College of Agriculture and Life Sciences within the Department of Food, Bioprocessing and Nutrition Sciences, and I run the CRISPR lab. So CRISPR stands for Clustered Regularly Interspaced Short Palindromic Repeats, CRISPR, together with associated sequences called Cas genes, CRISPR-associated genes, constitute the CRISPR-Cas immune system. And this is an immune system in bacteria that is arguably equivalent to the adaptive immune system in mammals and vertebrates, except it's DNA-encoded, RNA-mediated, sequence-specific targeting. And what CRISPR is a fancy system that allows you to selectively cut double-stranded DNA selectively, specifically, efficiently, and affordably. And it has changed the world of genetic studies and genome editing specifically, with huge implications across three different types of industries. One is the biotechnology industry, obviously. Another one is food and ag, and the development of strains and organisms of interest for the ag industry, going all the way up the supply chain. And last but not least, translational medicine and the genesis of disease model systems for human applications. And also gene therapy to correct flawed genes in human cells. It's really giving rise to a technology that's going to make a difference in the real world. And industrially, we've seen that happen already. And if you use yogurt, or if you consume yogurt, or if you consume cheese on a daily basis or regular basis, it's happened already. You have used a CRISPR-enhanced product. You've consumed a CRISPR-enhanced product, and that's the role of a land-grant institution like NC State to really make a difference for the industry and consumers on a very large, broad scale. But beyond this, for biotechnology and translational medicine, we've seen promise recently in the CRISPR literature with people being able to excise inserted HIV-1 viruses out of human cells, or be able to rewrite and edit genome sequences that are implicated in liver cancer, DMD, Duchenne's muscular dystrophy, whereby you're able to go into a genome and really change the content of the genome to make it right and correct it. In closing, clearly CRISPR is a very compelling topic. Now is the right time. NC State and our lab is the right place. We have the right team. And it's providing tremendous business opportunities and actual deliverables that are pertinent to different industries. And as we've seen from VCs and large companies, it is a very sound investment. And it has happened already. And now the question is, how far will people take the technology, and how creative people will be in their use of CRISPR? And only future will tell how far they can go and how fast they'll get there.